हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल अनफॉग विद डॉक्टर अतहर परवीन। दिस चैनल इज ए प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर फ्री क्लासेस मेजरली डेडिकेटेड टू कर्नाटका टीचर रिक्रूटमेंट एग्जाम्स लाइक टीईटी, एचएसटीआर दैट इज हाई स्कूल टीचर रिक्रूटमेंट, जीपीएसटीआर दैट इज ग्रेजुएट प्राइमरी स्कूल टीचर रिक्रूटमेंट फॉर फिजिक्स, मैथ्स, केमिस्ट्री एंड बायोलॉजी। This is the third class based on GPSTR biology syllabus for the chapter Reaching the Age of Adolescence. Actually, many aspirants were requesting us for a GPSTR biology demo classes. So that's why we had conducted a poll in our Telegram channel also. So we got a majority of yes in the poll. So that's why because there is a demand for demo classes, we are giving these classes as demo classes. Now these series of classes are actually taken from our GPSTR paid course. You can take these classes as free demo classes, and you can also decide on whether you want to take up the paid course or no. Please note that these classes will be useful for GPSTR PM method aspirants, GPSTR CB method aspirants, HSTR CB method aspirants, and of course TET aspirants also. So in our previous classes, I mean to say last two classes based on this chapter, we have discussed about adolescence, puberty, primary and secondary sexual characteristics, both in male and female. Then we had also discussed about difference between endocrine and exocrine glands. We also told that we can expect 2 to 3 marks questions as descriptive questions from any one of these, or we may also expect as a MCQ from any of these. Okay. Now in this class, we will see in detail the pituitary, thyroid, pancreas and adrenal. Okay, so stay tuned for I think next 10 minutes or so to get to know the details about all this, and along with that we will also discuss the concept about the menstruation. Even this we can expect for 2 to 3 marks in the exam. Okay, so let us start the class. First, let's talk about pituitary gland. I told you about this pituitary gland, that it is also known as master gland, right? So it is a master endocrine gland. This is actually regulating all the hormones secreted. Okay, now this pituitary gland, where it is situated? It is situated in the brain. Okay, and it is called master endocrine gland. They can ask as a MCQ. Dash is situated in the brain and is called a master endocrine gland. Or they can say, they can ask a question like this. This is a master endocrine gland. You should be knowing that it is pituitary gland. It is producing hormones which are actually regulating other glands to secrete their hormones. And pituitary gland being itself an endocrine gland, it is also secreting one hormone. We call it as a growth hormone. This controls the overall growth of a person. Okay, now secretion of a growth hormone is actually maximum only in this adolescence period. Okay, you get my point, right? Next is a thyroid gland. Now this gland is having the shape of a butterfly, and it is situated in the throat. Where was pituitary gland situated? It was situated in the brain. Thyroid gland is situated in the throat. This is secreting a hormone called thyroxin. Now this thyroxin is very, very important because it maintains the balance of all metabolic activities. If the person has the deficiency of this hormone, then there will be some swelling of this thyroid gland, and this will lead to a disorder or disease called goiter. Okay, so if there is a question like this,
The deficiency of thyroxine causes this disease. You should be knowing that it is goiter. Okay. Now let's talk about other glands like pancreas and adrenal glands. Now what are these pancreas? These are those glands that secrete a hormone called insulin. So mostly all of us know about this because someone, at least one family member is there only nowadays who is suffering from diabetes. This is the story of every household nowadays. So this diabetes is caused due to deficiency of insulin. Now this insulin is a hormone which is secreted by pancreas. The function of this insulin is to regulate the blood sugar level in the body. Okay. Now let's talk about the next one, which is adrenal glands. Now this adrenal glands, they are situated right above the kidney. Now these glands release hormones called adrenaline. Okay. Now this glands actually change their shape throughout our life and they shrink as we grow older. They secrete this adrenaline and they also maintain the salt and pH balance in our body. So this adrenaline is actually one of the most important hormone, as it is called as a fight or flight hormone. Because it is playing very important role during emergency situations. Wherever if we are in trouble, say that I am sitting in a giant wheel in the exhibition. So I feel something like very scared, right? At that time, this adrenaline is released and this helps us in emergency situations like that. Okay, so that's why it is called as a fight or flight hormone. Now here I have a picture where you can see the location of the glands in our body. Actually, why I am giving this picture means I thought that in case they ask you to show the location of the glands in our body, then you should be knowing. And also when you read and prepare, if you know the location, then also things will become easy for you. Okay, so you can see the pituitary gland in brain, thyroid gland in throat, and adrenal gland above the kidney, and so on. Okay. So these are the endocrine glands of human. Now let's talk about menstrual cycle. Now this becomes important for this chapter because this is a reproductive process in females. So I don't think they will ask a question on this, but better know it because you never know. In case they ask a MCQ also, you should be knowing the concept, right? So what is menstruation means? There will be the flow of blood which occurs every month in women. This is not observed in men, and this thing is actually beginning from puberty and it may stop at the age of 45 to 50 years. Now what is the starting of this menstruation called, or the first time menstruation is called as a menarche? They can ask as a MCQ. Menarche. Okay, so a female can get a menarche at the time of puberty, maybe from 10 to 12 years, but it will change. That can change from person to person. It may come till 15 years also. Okay, next, the ending of this. The ending means what is the age I am telling? The age can be 45 to 50 years. We call it as menopause. This also can be asked as a MCQ. Okay, so 45 to 50 years of age, a female can suffer with this menopause. Okay, where the menstruation cycle actually stops. So a girl child, see this is important. A girl child will first go through menarche, then menopause, then comes a old age. Okay, clear, right? Now in case they ask for 3 to 4 marks to draw or to explain the cycle of this menstruation, that's why I am giving you these points also. So in a female, when the puberty reaches, ovaries are developed. Now what are these ovaries? They are actually the one which release the ovum or the egg. Now, one ovum will maturate once in a month. It can be for every 28 to 30 days. It is a cycle. Mensuration is a cycle. Okay. So, uterus is developing a thick wall to receive these eggs, which are released by the ovaries. Now, this ovum, if it is fertilized by egg, then it will lead to pregnancy. This is the situation at that time. Okay, so if the ovum is fertilized by the egg, it will lead to pregnancy. If it is not fertilized, then what happens? The thick lining of uterus and blood vessel, they are all shed by the body and there is a blood flow. This is the one at that time. Okay, so because of this, mensuration happens. And this mensuration can happen from 2 to 8 days. Every menstrual cycle will have menstrual flow from 2 to 8 days. And as I already told you, this cycle repeats every month. And this is called as menstrual cycle. Okay, clear, right?
So this was all about today's class. We really hope that these classes help you. We will continue this class in the next session. Okay? Thank you. All the best. Bye.